Hey there! In this video, we're going to be examining audio editing in Mixcraft in a bit more detail. We'll be taking a look at warping, as well as manually setting Eclipse key and tempo. To begin, I've got a drum loop here that I'm pretty happy with, but I want to add some percussion to. Let's take a listen. Whenever I'm making my drums, I really like to use sounds that I've made and recorded myself. That being said, to finish this off, I want to add a recording of some silverware to use as a percussion loop. Let's dig through my sounds here and find something relatively long with some interesting rhythm to it. I think this one will work. Let's go up to the top and select Insert Audio Track, and then place our silverware loop here in this track. If we take a listen to this as it is now, it has some interesting rhythm, but it's not really at any specific tempo because it's just a recording of me messing with silverware. That being said, it really won't fit in with our drum groove here. Let's take a listen. To fix this, we can use warping. Warping is a very powerful creative tool that allows you to take things that aren't at a specific tempo or time and adjust them to fit a specific tempo or time. To access the warping functions, we'll double-click on the top of this clip here. This will open the sound editor. Let's expand this window so we can see things a bit better. If you take a look up here at the top, we can see the beats and bar lines, and we see that none of this is really at any specific point. It's kind of all over the place. To fix this and set this to be in tempo with the rest of our drum groove, we can click the warp button here. This enables warping, but hasn't quite done anything yet. To warp this clip to get in time, we can use the quantize function. Just like quantizing MIDI, this allows you to set things to a specific note value. In this case, I want to go for 16th notes as this whole drum groove is based around some swung 16ths. The sensitivity here determines how many warp markers will be placed in a clip. Generally speaking, it's best to leave this between a value of 60 to 70, but you might need to experiment with it. The strength will determine how aggressive of corrections Mixcraft will apply to the clip. In my case, I want things to remain fairly organic, so I'm going to leave this at about 70%. That way it's correcting things, but not making it overly robotic. Finally, we have the swing setting here, and like I said, this whole drum groove is based around some swung 16ths, so I'm going to add about 35% swing to this clip. Now, we can hit OK, and you'll see that the clip is warped to fit in time. Let's go back and take another listen now that it's been warped. That's sounding a lot better, but we might need to go in and apply some quick corrections. If we take a look over here and zoom in, you'll notice that this wasn't quite corrected right onto the beat here. To fix that, we can manually correct the warping. To do that, we'll go up here to the top and make sure our snap to grid setting is off. Now, we'll go over here to this red line and hold shift once we see the two arrows appear, and then click and drag to align this more to the grid. From here, you can go in and repeat this as needed, or add new warp markers by double-clicking and then dragging them around. Now that we've applied some manual corrections, let's take another listen. Pretty cool stuff, right? To finish this out, let's copy a segment of this over here, that way we can fill out two bars, and then we'll duplicate that to fill out all four bars of our drum groove. Let's go here to bar 3 and click and drag about 2 beats worth, then we'll use Ctrl-C to copy, go over here, and Ctrl-V to paste. There's a little bit of a gap here, but we can fix this by resizing the clip by clicking and dragging to fill that out. To duplicate this over and fill out all four bars, we'll go over and highlight these two clips, hold Alt, and then click and drag. Now, we've filled out all four bars with our silverware percussion loop. Let's check it out. As I'm sure you can imagine, warping is a very powerful creative tool that allows you to do a lot of things with sound and manipulate it in some interesting ways. However, in the grander scheme of things, it's also a very handy tool to apply small corrections to a performance. If your guitar playing was slightly out of time, you can use warping to get it in time. If you did a really good drum take but something wasn't quite on the beat, you can use warping to correct that. Or, if you've stacked several vocal parts together, you can use warping in each of the clips to warp them to all fit together in time. Now, let's add something melodic into this groove. Once again, we'll go up to the top here and select Insert Audio Track. Then we can go to my library and find a melodic loop. Okay, after a bit of digging, I found this one here, which I really like. It's just a really interesting, crunchy music box recording I did. Let's drag this into our project. And you'll notice it's not in tempo. Every clip in Mixcraft has its own individual tempo and key settings that you can apply to it. With that in mind, we can use that to correct this clip to fit into the project's tempo and the project's key. If you take a look at the loop name, you'll see that this is at 108 beats per minute in the key of D minor, whereas our project is at 140 in the key of C. To correct this, we'll double-click the clip, and then in the sound editor over to the left-hand side, we'll select Use Project Tempo and Use Project Key. Mixcraft will automatically try to determine the clip's tempo and key. In this case, the tempo wasn't quite right, but it did get the key right. Let's enter the original clip tempo, which is 108 beats per minute. Now, you'll see it's been warped automatically to 140 beats per minute, and therefore fits our 4-bar groove. If we take a listen, you'll hear it's automatically also been transposed down into the key of C. This is great because it allows us to change our project tempo and key on the fly. Let's try that out by changing the tempo to 132 beats per minute, and let's change our project to the key of F. If we take a look down here, you'll notice our silverware percussion didn't warp. That's because we need to go in and apply the tempo to these clips. To do that, we'll click and drag over all of the clips here, and then go to Use Project Tempo and enter their original tempo, which was 140. Now, these have been stretched to fit this new tempo of 132. Let's take a listen. And if we decide that didn't work and we go back to 140 and let's say the key of A, this has been changed once again automatically. Like I mentioned, this is great because if you're working on a song and decide you want to change the project key or tempo on the fly, you can easily do that whenever inspiration strikes. Warping and clip editing are very powerful tools inside of Mixcraft that allow you to do a lot of creative and interesting things with audio, or apply small corrections as needed. And I think that does it for this video, so thanks for watching.